martial arts to traditional medicine, from puppetry to science and engineering, from literature to sports, women in Kerala have proved themselves time and again in every walk of life. At a time when the world is far from equal for women, many of them from various parts of the state have been recognized for their contributions in their respective fields. Some women among them have etched their names in the annals of Padma Shri history. On this Women's Day, Onmanorama brings you to 9 women from this prestigious group of awardees. With 6 national awards, 35 state awards and over 2,500 songs sung in more than 8 languages, no wonder K. Chitra is called the Nightingale of South India. Born in 1963, she started singing professionally at the age of 16 and has recorded over 25,000 songs in different languages. Chitra is known for her emotional rendering. Her songs will mesmerize you with pangs of pain and love. A celebrated poet and a tireless crusader of the weaker sections of the society, Sugata Kumari often reflected and addressed the appalling side of human lives through her poems. She was bestowed with honours including the Kerala Sahitya Academy Award and Padma Shri for her works. As a poet and writer, Sugata Kumari has left a memorable mark on her own in the field of Malayalam literature. Now in her 70s, as a poet, teacher and a social activist, Sugata Kumari has her roles cut out to perform with the same vivacity and purposefulness. With around 230 films and 2 national awards in her kitty, dancer-actor Shobna paved her way through the hearts of Malayalis with her incredible performance in Fazil's Manachitrathaadu. As an accomplished Bharatanatyam dancer, Shobna hails from the family of the famous Travancore sisters. She emerged as an independent performer and choreographer in her 20s. In 2006, the Indian government honoured Shobna with Padma Shri for her contributions to the art. She is also the founder of classical dance school Kalarpana in Chennai. Writer, critic, teacher and an orator, Leelavathi Teacher is an inspiration and a prominent face in Malayalam literature. Leelavathi Teacher was honoured and considered as the first woman to make substantial contributions to the genre of literary criticism in Malayalam. In 2010, she also received the Eduthachan Puraskaram, the highest literary prize in Kerala. During her long literary career, she won several awards and honours, including the Odukural Award and the Kerala Sahitya Academy Award. Varnaraji, Kavida Dwani, Appu and Anveshanam are some of her notable works. One of the most accomplished exponents of Mohiniyattam, Kshemavathi pursued her classical dance training from the renowned Kerala Kalamandalam. One of the senior most exponents of the dance form, she has been contributing to the growth of Mohiniyattam for the past 50 years and still counting. In 2011, the Government of India honoured her with Padma Shri for her notable contributions in the field of Mohiniyattam. She is also a recipient of Sangeet Natak Academy Award and Nrityanata Puraskara. Commonly regarded as the matriarch of classical dance form Mohiniyattam, Kalamandalam Satyabhama helped to make the traditional art form popular among dance buffs. Known for her experimental reforms in Mohiniyattam, she has also made some phenomenal contributions in the costume and jewellery of Mohiniyattam as we see it today. Honoured to be Kalamandalam's first woman vice principal, Kalamandalam Satyabhama is the crowning glory of Mohiniyattam. Meenakshi Amma, also known as Meenakshi Gurukal, defies her age with the twirl of her sword. Being one of the oldest women Kalaripayattu gurus, Meenakshi Amma was associated with this martial art, which was mostly practiced by men, at the age of 17. She teaches Kalaripayattu to more than 150 students in the small town of Vadagara without any fee. In 1940, when Parashalabi Ponnamma got a grade as a singer with the All India Radio, she was just 16. She was also the first female student to enroll in the Swathi Thirunal College of Music in Thiruvananthapuram during the early 1940s. Despite being a music teacher for so long and teaching music to thousands of students, Ponnammal Teacher lived a quiet and primarily forgotten public life. Even after acquiring the greatest treasure of music, Parashalabi Punnamma's only way of life has to be to present classical Carnatic music in her concerts and to pass it on to the next generation of musicians. Pankajakshi can be called as one of the last surviving link to the traditional art of Nokavidya Pavakali, a form of traditional puppetry. The art form, which is believed to be 5 centuries old, requires the performer to balance puppets on their upper lip and manage the movements of the puppets with constant gaze and by controlling the strings. From the age of 8, Pankajakshi has been carrying on the legacy of performing this indigenous art from across India and the world.